Okay, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. We're here again for our daily sessions with retired Navy SEAL Captain John Doolittle. He and his wife, Katie, who will be participating, are logging in from St. Petersburg, Florida. That's on the west coast of Florida. I'm from Huntington Beach, California. A little bit close to Disneyland.
They cancel.
Today, John will be doing a variety of exercises, and we always want to remind people if the exercises are too difficult, too long, etc. Always modify as you see fit. If John is going to do 10 push-ups and you could only do 5, or you've got a shoulder injury, just do something else instead. These are just suggestions. And John is a 25 year of the U.S. Navy, is a pretty hardened, fit man. So we can't always keep up with him. So go ahead, John. Take over.
Yeah, keep going with that, Stephen. I like it. Hey, everybody, I'm excited to be with you. If your mic is on, go ahead and mute it, please. And special hello to my mom, who's out in Bodega Bay, California. There she is. She's waving, getting ready for a total knee replacement, doing a lot of KAATSU. So today's focus is on stamina, okay? So sometimes we work. There's Katie. Wave hi, Katie. All right. We got the dogs underneath me all ready to go. And so we're going to do some stamina. We're going to start with some arm work, but just a little bit on arm. We're going to focus mostly today on lower body, on your lower extremities, on your legs. So go ahead and grab your KAATSU Cycle 2.0, and let's go ahead and take arm bands first. Now, easiest with the arm bands, if you have the tube already connected, we've talked about that before, right? And ideally, we want this 90 degree elbow facing down towards our fingers. So we go ahead, stick this on all the way up into our armpit and give it a nice snug. It should be tight enough that it's tough to get a finger under the band, but I can, okay? If I can get two fingers under that band, that's too loose. So we want that on pretty snug, okay? And again, the tube's already connected. Go ahead and do the other side here. All the way up to the armpits. It's easiest if you have it kind of preset, and then you just sort of slide it on there. I like to have the material all the way under the band, and then I just give it a nice little pull. Make sure I can get a finger under the band, which I can. All right. And now I have the two tubes ready to be plugged into the cycle. Go ahead, turn the cycle on, push and hold the power button. And you'll hear a beep and you'll see the word cycle come up. Go ahead and plug into the side of the cycles. I know some of you are working with the KAATSU Nano, so just bear with us on this part. Mom, I know you're using the Nano. You still can do everything with the Nano that we're doing here today on the cycle. I'm going to start at group medium. You could start at group low, start at group high if you want, but I like group medium. That's a good starting place for me. And I've already done some KAATSU earlier today when I was doing some emails. So my arms are already pretty much warmed up. All right, so what we're gonna do is combine three different exercises into the arms. So go ahead and just connect to your belt wherever it's comfortable for you. You can stick it in your pocket. You can connect it to your belt, to your shorts. And we're gonna combine three exercises for the warm-up, okay? But before we get into the warm-up, let's go ahead and just do some light stretching. The cycle should be running. If you have the nano, you should be in the cycle right now. Pressure on, pressure off. The nano's 20 seconds on, 5 seconds off. If you have this one, it's 30 seconds on, 5 seconds off. So let's go ahead and just get it some shoulder rolls all the way up to your ears. Back. Kind of move your neck around. Just get some shoulder rolls, rolling your shoulders back. There's four, let's get five each direction. Now roll your shoulders forward. There we go. Nice day in St. Pete. It's about high 70s. Sun's poking through the clouds a little bit. Not too much wind, not enough for kiteboarding. Not that any of us are doing that right now. All right, that's good. Go ahead and one arm over and just pull down, pull your hand down your spine. And if you want, go ahead and help with the other hand. Just give it a light stretch. And these stretches don't have to match with the cycles. Just let the cycles run in the background. Go ahead, get the other arm. Light stretch. You don't need much, just light stretch. All right. Pull one arm across. You can bend your arm if that's more comfortable. I like the feeling of having it straight, a little more of a stretch. Same with the other direction. All right. Go ahead and turn your head, circles one direction, and then the other. All right, let's loosen up our hips just a little bit. Go ahead and lift your knee, twist to the outside. Lift the knee, twist to the outside. Let's do this three times on each side. Just because we have the arm bands on doesn't mean that we can't warm up the whole body. Because you get the systemic effect. KAATSU, you always hear us talk about systemic effects. Put your hands on your hips. Just do some slow hip circles, one direction. Let's go three each direction. That's good. And then the other direction. All right. And that's good. Okay, you ready to do some stuff? All right, so we're gonna start with a combination of three exercises. There's the hand clench, there's a bicep curl, and there's a tricep extension. We're gonna combine all three of those. We're gonna go 30, 20, 10. So, bicep curl to a tricep extension and fingers all the way extended. We're combining three exercises, right? We got the hand clench, bicep curl, tricep extension. So tight fist, let's go ahead and start. Tricep extension and hands all the way open, that's two. All right, and there's three, nice and tight. There's four, you count for me, Katie, while I kind of run my yap here. We're doing 30 of these. All right, all the way up, extension, full extension to your fingers. Tight fist, full extension, fully open. Engaged, everything engaged, never letting anything rest, right? So I'm either working in extension or I'm working in flexion. This is extending everything. This is flexing everything, including my hands, my wrists, my forearms, tricep, everything, all right? Katie just restarted her cycle. If you hear a double beep, just reach down and push the low or medium or pro, whichever, low, medium, high, whichever button you're working on. What are we at, 16? Okay, we got 14 more of these. Good. This is just warming us up. Warming the whole body up. Okay, 10 more. Okay, now these next 10, let's go ahead and do these nice and fast. Ready, begin. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Okay, shake it out. Let's go ahead and check our cap refill. Wait for the cycle to be at pressure. And you don't want this to remain white longer than 3 seconds. And my pressure just released. I'm gonna restart, there we go. Okay, that's enough rest. Now we're going again, doing 20. All right, here we go. Same thing. Tight and extend. Everything's tight and extend. There's two, three, four, five. And you quickly find that you do not only do you not need heavy weights to get some metabolic stress, but you really don't need any weights. That's 10, we're halfway there. 2 seconds up, 2 seconds down. Good. Everything distal of the bands. I don't know about you, we're going for 20. Oh yeah, let's do the last five fast. Ready? And begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, shake it out. Just get in the habit of checking your cap refill. 1,000, 2,000. Good. Handle a little more pressure. You got some tingling on my fingertips, but no numbness and no pain ever. Never numbness, never pain. Tingling, totally okay. All right, last set, we're going 10. Ready? Up and fully extend. Up, fully extend. Up, fully extend. That's 3, 4, 5, and then five fast. Ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Woo! That'll warm you up. Okay, guys, go ahead and tap the power button, turn it off, and let's take the armbands off. The whole idea there was to warm ourselves up for the real work, leg bands. All right, if you're using some equipment, like mom, you're on your recumbent bike, that's okay. Just make sure that how you set up your tubes, that the tubes are not going to be in the way. So if you need to loop them over the handle of the bike or what have you. All right, leg bands. If you guys have been tuning in each day, you're going to get sick of me doing this. But of all the things we see with KAATSU, the biggest mistakes are the way people put the leg bands on. So I'm always going to do this. I'm always going to harp on this. All the way up on the inside of your thigh. Make sure that it's not behind you on your butt where you're going to sit on it and not on the inside of your thigh. Make sure that the tube is somewhere on the outside of your leg. And while you're standing up, just go ahead. Don't tighten it down yet. Just get it on there snug. We'll tighten it in a second. And take the other side. All right, here we go. All the way up. Poses on the outside. Once you start getting used to this, it becomes second nature. And if you look, if you guys take a look at how they're riding on me right now, they're all the way up in the middle and they're a little bit higher on the outside. They're not straight across, they're a little higher on the outside. So even guys that have crazy strong, big quadriceps and hamstrings, that's the smallest part of the upper leg, and that's where you want these things to be. Now let's tighten them down. Go ahead and sit on the edge of a chair or bench or couch or whatever. Relax the quads and the hamstrings and the glutes, and then really cinch that thing down. Get some good tightness on there. Same on the other side. Legs nice and relaxed. Steven, can you see this okay?
There's a little you're a little bit in the shade. So okay. It's a little bit difficult to see. If you can...
Woo!
Oh, there you go. There you go.
All right.
Good.
All right, so once again, legs nice and relaxed. And you really can cinch it down nice when the legs relax. And here's the key. Now that's tight, but I can get my finger under there. Definitely I can get my finger in there. But if I try to put two fingers under the band, not really. It's a little too much. That's where we want to be. Tighter on the legs than we were on the arms. You got so much muscle and tissue in your legs. It's virtually impossible to occlude this arterial flow when you're using these bands, all right? Remember, the bands are elastic pneumatic bladders, so we want these things nice and tight, okay? Once you got the bands on, then we can go ahead and hook up to the Cycle 2.0 or the Nano, whatever you're using. And we're gonna do, there's no equipment needed today for what we're doing on legs. This is all gonna be body weight. Most of the moves we've done in the past, but if you're first time joining us for the first time, we'll go through some of that. So we're gonna do some untethered training mode, but not right now. Right now, let's stay in the cycle mode. I am on my legs, I like to be pro, medium. And then when I reset it, I'll go pro high on my next one. You can start at pro low, you can start at group low. It's total personal preference. And you'll figure out pretty quick what works best for you. Okay, first leg exercise. These are gonna be calf raises. So we're gonna do 30 seconds up, a 10 second hold, and then 20 seconds of rest. Okay, I know on the workout list out, it says three times. Everywhere it says three times for this group, for the baby boomer group, we're gonna do it twice. And everywhere it says two times, we're gonna do it once. If there's any exercise that you can't do because of some sort of physical limitation, just go ahead and do what you can. If you can't balance on one leg without holding something, go ahead and use the back of a chair. If you need to put your foot down for balance, absolutely do that. If you can't do regular push-ups, when we're not doing any, we do. Yeah, I don't think we're doing any push-ups with this one. Yeah, but Katie will help us modify. So the first one here, calf raises, 30 seconds up, 10 second hold, and then rest for 20 seconds. And we're gonna do that twice, all right? Let me get the stopwatch going here. Oh, okay. All right, here we go. And ready, begin. So calf raises, we're going up for 2 seconds, down for 2 seconds, up and down, up and down. 2 seconds up, 2 seconds down. If you have to let your heels rest on the ground, that's fine. If you can do it where your heels never rest on the ground, that's even better. If this is too much and you want to do this from a seated position, absolutely, you can do that. You can do the same movement. All right, go ahead and hold it in the up position now, 10 seconds. If this is too much, use this 10 seconds as part of your rest. 3, 2, 1, and relax. Shake it out. Okay, we're gonna do that again. We got 10 seconds of rest. You good?
Yep.
All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, and 30 seconds. Down, 2 seconds up, 2 seconds down, seconds up, and down, and down. Very nice. Okay, 15. Halfway there, 10 more seconds. Looking good. I see a bunch of heads bobbing on the screen. That's good. All right, 3, 2, 1, and hold it up. Hold it in the up position. Use a chair if you need to. 3, 2, 1, and relax. All right, good. If you have some equipment, and mom, I'm looking at you right now, and you wanna go ahead and start the movements on the equipment in the cycle phase, absolutely, you can do that. Just make sure that you're in the cycle. Okay, so same idea as the calf raises, only now we're gonna move to leg curls. Third of movement, and in 10 seconds of hold, and 20 seconds of rest and shake it out. Okay, here we go, ready, begin. So leg curl, 2 seconds up, 2 seconds down. If you can balance on one leg, great. If that's asking a little much, use the back of a chair. If you're using the back of a chair and you don't need to hold on with both hands and just maybe a finger to just kind of help yourself with just a finger, that's perfect. Five more seconds. There we go. And hold that leg up. Hold it. Try to balance. Try to have good posture. 3, 2, 1. All right, shake it out. Okay, now we're moving to the other leg, same idea. And going in 3, 2, 1, go. All right, 30 seconds of movement. 2 seconds up, 2 seconds down. Up and down. Good. All right, coming up on the halfway mark, 15 more seconds. Really engage that hamstring. Try not to let it rest and try not to let your leg just drop down. 3, 2, 1, and hold it up. Hold it up for 10 seconds. 5 more. 3, 2, 1, and relax. All right, good job. All right, now we're gonna go into some quarter squats. Instead of 30 seconds of movement, we're just gonna do 20 seconds of movement, a 10 second hold, and then 20 seconds of rest. Okay, now when we're doing this with the competitive athletes and these guys hear quarter squats, they go all the way down, they're just being really aggressive. I don't want you guys to do that. I want you to just, I'm gonna do it on the back of a chair here so you can see what I'm talking about. When I say quarter squat, just go down to there. It doesn't, you don't need much, right? We don't need to go all the way down like this. This is not CrossFit, okay? We just want to engage all the hamstrings and quads and glutes and then squeeze it up and then right back into it. Don't let yourself rest in the up position either. Don't lock your legs out and rest. Just keep everything moving, okay? All right, so it's gonna be 20 seconds of work and a 10 second hold and then 20 seconds rest. We'll do that twice. All right, you ready? Oh, and last thing, try to have your butt go back so your knees stay behind your toes. We're not looking for this, we're looking for more of this, okay? All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, begin. All right. 2 seconds up, 2 seconds down. Just keep continuous movement. And we're keeping everything firing and moving with the hamstrings, glutes, and quads. That's good. 3, 2, 1, and now hold. Just hold in the quarter squat position. Just enough that those quads are firing. 3, 2, 1, shake it out. All right, good. If you had a double beep on your cycle, go ahead and start it again. 10 more seconds, not too hard, right? It's good. All right, 5 seconds. Okay, 3, 2, 1, same thing. Nice. All right, how are we looking, Steven?
Good, good. Here, I notice you have matching shirts today.
Oh, yes, we are matching. They're not the exact same, but they're the same color at least. Yeah. And 3, 2, 1, and go ahead and hold that quarter squat position. 5 seconds, 3, 2, 1, and shake it out. All right. Let the cycle keep running in cycle mode and go find your water. So Buck and Cody are not in enjoying this warmer weather. They're hiding in the shade right now.
John, we had question, and this actually comes up a lot with our users generally over the age of 50. Okay. And they were wondering if there are any contraindications. Is there anything dangerous or risky if you're older and then taking blood pressure medication or the like. And I want to remind everybody.
So when I get asked about contraindications, my response is always, I just give the overarching basics. And then if they want more details, I push them towards the literature. But basically, anybody that has a history of seizures, has a history of heart disease, and is on any kind of medication or care of a cardiologist, and anybody that's pregnant. Those are the big three. Now, I say that, and then I tell them in the same breath, the irony is that in Japan, they do KAATSU for all three of those. But here in the US, because we're not an FDA cleared device yet, we have to be careful, right? We have to make sure if anybody is pregnant, has a history of heart disease, or is on heart medications, or if they have a history of seizure, they need to go get clearance from their doctor. But this is essentially a light intensity exercise. So if you are cleared from your doc to work out, then more often than not, you're this. But in those three categories, absolutely get clearance from your physician. Make sense?
Thank you, John.
Okay. All right. All right. This next exercise is standing lunges. Now, I understand some people in the audience are not going to be able to do a standing lunge all the way with your knee to the ground, okay? And that's fine. If a standing lunge for you is stepping forward and just bending your knee a little bit and coming back, no problem. Whatever is comfortable for you. If this is all you can get, that's fine. If you can get this, that's fine too, okay? So what we're gonna do is 30 seconds of all left leg forward and then 20 seconds of rest. Then we'll do 30 seconds of all right leg forward, just at a moderate pace, just like that, and then 20 seconds of rest. And we're gonna do that twice, okay? All right, and Katie will show a modified standing lunge. Okay, here we go, starting with 30 seconds in 3, 2, 1, and begin. Just your left leg forward and back. Just your left leg forward and back. Just your left leg and back. As far as is comfortable. If all you can do is bend your knees 10 degrees and come back to standing, totally fine. The idea here is to be moving in a lunging position at some level. All right, 3, 2, 1, and shake it out. All right, we got 15 more seconds. And now we're gonna go to the right leg forward. All standing lunges, stepping forward on your right leg. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and begin. It's not a race. Don't worry about reps. The idea that these are slow and controlled movements, okay? Nice, halfway there. 10 more seconds. Okay, 5, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Remember, you can check capillary refill on your legs, just like your arms. Pick an area above your knee if you're wearing shorts and look for that to stay white no longer than 3 or 4 seconds. It's really 3 seconds on your hands, 4 seconds on your legs. Okay. Here we go, same thing again, okay? Starting in 3, 2, 1, begin. Now, if this is easy for you, you can make it a little bit harder by just going down. But what you'll find is pretty quickly, that gets hard. I'm going right back to normal. 3, 2, 1, and relax. 20 seconds more rest. How you doing? Let's modify COVID-19 stuff. All right. Trying to have fun with it. I know we're all locked up. Glad you guys are on with us. 5 seconds. Okay, opposite leg forward. Ready? Begin. 30 seconds of work. 2 seconds down. 2 seconds up. All right, 20 seconds, 20 more. Good. 15, halfway. Want to have some fun. Leave that hand, foot planted forward. Just go right into them. Woo. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and shake it out. Okay. Good job. Grab some water. Okay. Remember yesterday we did, actually we're going to save that mountain climber set for the competitive athletes this afternoon. And we're going to go into some jumps, some burpees, if you can. And we'll talk about ways to modify that. And then a couple of mountain climbers, and then we'll be done. But what we want to do first is we want to untether. So what does untether mean for KAATSU Cycle 2.0? I want to have these leg bands at consistent pressure. And because I'm going to jump around a little bit and I'm going to be going up and down, I don't want this box and tubes in the way. So I'm going to go ahead and untether. And the way we do that, we find the neutral mode, just tap the power button in the middle, and then turn, you'll see the L on top, push and hold the L, and the words on the front will change from cycle to training. So I'm gonna go ahead and push P to bring the pressure up. It goes up 10 millimeters mercury every time I tap it. SKU, standard KAATSU units. And I'm gonna put mine, I did it at 350 with you guys yesterday. That was a little much for me. I'm gonna put it at 330. So pick a pressure that you think is good for you. And if you're guessing, that's okay. And you'll figure out pretty quick if the pressure that you guessed is maybe a little too much for you. All right. Pardon? Accept. If you have it, once you get to the pressure button, it will start inflating. There you go. Good question. Yep. Okay, so mine's inflated. So you can see right there, I'm at, had a little bit longer to go. I must have been sitting on a tube. There we go. I am at 330. So to untether, adjust the camera so you can see it here. To untether, I'm taking the male end with finger and thumb and the female end with forefinger and thumb, push the clip and give it a little twist and it just comes apart. And there's a one-way check valve in here so the air doesn't leak out. And then I go to the other side, do the same thing, push, twist. And now I have 330 SKU in each band. You can go ahead and turn this off now. We're not gonna need it again. And now we're gonna do some jumps focusing on stamina. Now, if you cannot jump and you're not comfortable jumping, you have bad knees and what have you, I'm gonna put this a little lower so you can see our feet. The idea is we're gonna go for 30 seconds, and we're just gonna jump up and down, 30 seconds with the toes leaving the ground. Okay, if you cannot jump, if you have bad knee, bad hip, whatever that causes pain, or you, instead of jumping, march in place with high knees, okay? So 30 seconds of jumping, and then 20 seconds of rest. And then we're gonna go 30 seconds of jumping side to side, 20 seconds of rest. Again, if you can't do the jumps, just do the high knee marching. The idea is movement, 20 seconds of rest. Movement, 20 seconds of rest. Okay. Oh, and in the third set will be fore and aft jumps. And again, if you can't do that, high knee. Yeah, that's exactly. You could step forward, step back, step forward, step back. We don't want anybody to get hurt, but we got a wide variety of skills on this Zoom call today. All right, we ready to go?
Yep.
30 seconds, starting in 3, 2, 1, and begin. Okay, so if you're good enough that your toes are leaving the ground. Jumping's a little too much, high knee marching. If high knee marching is too much, low knee marching. Whatever you can do, movement, functional movement. All right, that's 25 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Rest for 20. Shake it out. Check your cap refill. Now, that might have felt okay, but because we're sustained consistent pressure, you're gonna start to feel it pretty quick here. Now we're jumping side to side. Pick a line on the floor and jump over it. Okay, and begin. Now if you can't jump, you can step side to side like Katie is, or if you like the high knee marching, you can do that. Whatever you want, that's 15 seconds. Very nice. All right, 10 seconds. All right, 5, it's a good ski exercise for dad. 3, 2, 1, and halt. All right, shake it out. Ooh, yeah. 15 more seconds. Good camera angle there, Stephen.
Yes, it is. Okay? Yes.
Good, good. 5 more seconds. This is fore and aft. 3, 2, 1, begin. If that hurts your knees, you definitely can do fore and aft and just keep it moving. If you don't like that, you can march whatever you want. 10 more seconds. All right. 5, 3, 2, and halt. Okay, shake it out. 20 seconds. All right. All right, that says 3 times. That's for the kids tonight. So we're gonna do it one more time. All right, 10 seconds. Going back to the 30 seconds of just up and down or high knee marching. Ready? Begin. So because the bands are not releasing and we're at this consistent pressure, what we call the training mode or untethered mode, my quads are burning. My calves, to a lesser degree, but it's also burning. 5 more seconds. And 3, 2, 1, and stop. 20 seconds. Okay, how you doing?
Good.
Feel a little burn?
Yeah.
Nice. Got a little sweat going. Florida sun. Oh. Okay, 5 more seconds. Side to side. 3, 2, 1, begin. Hitting that mogul field. Nice. Hitting that bump, backflip. 15 more seconds. Back in the day, 10 seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1, and halt. 20 seconds. All right, guys, last one of these. Last one of these. All right, 10 more seconds. Okay, 5, 4 now. 3, 2, 1, begin. Going for 30 seconds. And you don't have to jump far. And you don't have to step far. Woo! KAATSU! There we go, 10 more seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1, and halt. Okay. Whew. All right, if your legs aren't burning right now, you don't have your base pressure or your inflated pressure high enough. After that, you absolutely should be feeling winded and some good lactate response. Okay. All right, we'll save the burpees for the competitive athletes. We can modify. All right, here's what we're gonna do, guys. If you can do burpees, we're just gonna do 10 burpees.
Okay, John, we lost you here, but I will assume they're taking 10 burpees. So why don't you, everybody, begin on my count. John is frozen, and we'll do 10 casual burpees. Okay? Okay.
Step forward. Again, don't do anything that's... It's too crazy. I don't want anybody to get hurt. So let's try 10. Modify as you need. All right, you ready? All right, I'll do them right here. And begin. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Ooh. That was a family high five, a non-COVID high five. All right. We got a little more listed, but I'll tell you what, do more, go ahead and do more of the workout that you'll see on the link that we sent out. But I think for now, given how long we've gone, that's pretty good. So we'll go ahead and open it up. To some questions, audible, verbal, that's better for me because it's hard for me to see the chat room in here. We got any questions out there?
No, I think we have a lot of veterans here. Let's see if there's any questions coming in. And anybody could always email us.
Even while you anytime. Look. I was just going to say, while you're talking, I'm just depressurizing, taking the bands off and folding them up. So go ahead, Steven.
No, we'll call it a day today. Thank you very much, everybody, for coming. And we'll see you again on a regularly scheduled KAATSU at home Zoom sessions. If you have any friends or family that want to join us remotely, of course, virtually, of course, on Zoom, they're very welcome. Please feel free to share the links that we regularly put out. So thank you very much. Oh, and I'm going to send, there was a question. Share out the link with the exercises. Those are actually on www.kaatsublog.com. I'll say that
KAATSU
again.
KAATSUblog.com.
Is where all the exercises and recordings of these sessions are. And then John, can you review again, just show with your unit how to go from the cycle mode to the training mode and back once again. Just hold up your machine and just go from cycle to training mode.
Here, I'm going to shift angles a little bit here. Let me take the tubes off so it's easier. Okay. So your cycle 2.0, this is off, so obviously we got to be on. And when you see the word cycle, and these buttons are not lit up. If you have pro or group or pro lit, you need to go to the neutral position. And you just tap the power button. That puts you in the neutral position. And all you do to change from cycle to training is on the top of your machine, push and hold the L. I'm pushing and bam, you'll see it shift to training, okay? Once you're in training, you can push P to increase pressure. Or you can push G to lower the pressure, okay? And then once you pick a pressure, you tap that and it will start. And it will inflate the bands to whatever pressure you just picked. Now, you can stay tethered for the training mode, or you can untether. Usually when I'm doing the training mode, I like to untether, because if I'm doing training mode, that means I'm swimming, I'm jumping around, I'm doing jumping jacks, you know, burpees, whatever. I don't want the tubes hanging off of me, so I'll usually untether. When you're done with training mode and you want to go back to cycle mode, same thing. Whoops, sorry about that. Same idea. Just go back to that L. That L on top and push and hold, and it will change back to cycle, which is where it is when you turn it on. How's that?
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, John. Okay. Well, see you later, everybody. Until next time.
Guys, everyone, shaka.
Bye.